sucking bugs we all dread are now targeting our kids.
Some Brown County schools are the latest victims of this epidemic. News 5's Amy Wagner brings us the bedbug battle plan straight from school officials.
Well, leaders here at the Eastern Local School District have had to educate themselves lately on bedbugs. The first unwanted visitor appeared last year.
We had one incident last year, came up on a kid, and he had, "I've got a bug."
And since the start of this school year, several more have turned up at Sardinia Elementary School.
I think we've had 6 bugs total.
Not an infestation, but also not what officials at Eastern Local Schools want to be dealing with. But for the first time, a tri-state school is stepping up, admitting they've had a problem and giving us unprecedented access to see how they're dealing with it.
There are some other schools in the area that have it also. I think people are becoming more aware of it, and it's just trying to stay on top of it.
So how are they doing that? With regular exterminations. Clutter is banned from classrooms. So are the carpet remnants kids used to sit on. The real culprits, coats and bags, come and go in garbage bags, and each teacher is now armed with this.
Rubbing alcohol 70%. When you spray it, it'll kill the bugs immediately.
Parents, too, are on high alert. One of the pests was found in Victoria Lunsford's daughter's classroom.
My daughter came home with her coat and book bag bagged up with the information sheet saying that they had identified a bed bug.
She feels strongly that in the war against bed bugs, everybody needs to prepare for the battle.
If people deal with it and don't ignore it, then we can get a hold of it.
And the school has put its policy on bed bugs on their website, as well as a lot of useful information that all parents could learn from. It's on our website, WLWT.com. Just click on As Seen on WLWT. In Brown County, I'm Amy Wagner, News 5.